So in the previous video, we talked about matrix multiplication between a matrix and a vector. Let's now take this concept a little bit further and multiply two matrices. So while we don't need this yet for our perceptron, it will become very relevant when we talk about multi-layer neural networks later. So you can consider this as a sneak peek into the techniques we will be using. And where we will encounter this is later when we implement deep neural networks and do the matrix multiplication between the input training set and then the weight matrix. So if this looks confusing, don't worry about it yet. We will revisit this many times later on. In training deep neural networks, we often use a matrix multiplication because we have a weight matrix now. So the input is the same. We still have X as our training data set. However, we have now a weight matrix W. And in this weight matrix, the rows here represent the different features just as before. However, in addition to that, we also have columns now, and each column produces a different output. So in a sense, you can think of it as the perceptron's weighted sum, but with multiple outputs, where each column here refers to a different output. So in essence, you can think of this weight matrix as a weight matrix consisting of H weight vectors, where each weight vector corresponds to one output. So in order to multiply the input matrix X with the weight matrix W, we have to make sure that the dimensions match and that we are computing the right thing. So what we want to do here is just like before in the previous video, where we want to compute the dot product between each training example and each weight vector. So what we do for that is to transpose the weight matrix. So now each column on the right-hand side in the weight matrix corresponds to one weight vector. And then just like before, we can compute the dot product between each row in the data set X and the weight matrix W. So to obtain the first output value, what we do is we compute the dot product between the first row in the input matrix and the first column of the weight matrix. Then we continue like we just did in the previous video, and we compute the dot product between the second row of the input matrix and still the first column in our weight matrix. So again, the first column here represents the first weight vector. And then we keep going just like in the previous video and compute the dot product between each row in the input matrix and the weight vector. After we completed that, we can then now tackle the second column of the output matrix. It's the same concept that we again still compute the dot product between each row in the input matrix. So now the second column in the weight matrix becomes our weight vector. And we do that until again we have covered each single row in the input matrix and computed the dot product with the second column of the weight matrix. And we keep doing that until we covered all possible dot product combinations between the input matrix X and the weight matrix W. So as a result, the output matrix will have the same number of rows as the input matrix, and the output matrix will have the same number of columns as the weight matrix. Yeah, just for reference, here's an example of the matrix multiplication between X and W in PyTorch. This time in this video, we are skipping the benchmarking, but I encourage you as a viewer to do the benchmarking on your own and see how much faster this approach actually is compared to plain Python code. And now this was a sneak peek into matrix multiplication. And in the next video, we will see what broadcasting is, how we can work with tensors of different shapes.